Hi, this is Lovely Lovebird Designs, and today I will be showing you how to make this baby peacock, or mini peacock. This is the bigger one, which has actually five attached looms in the back, and it's very time consuming. And then this is the smaller one, which only has four shorter looms in the back connected, and it has a smaller body with no extensions. So it'll be faster to make, and it's still a large piece, and it's very beautiful. And I'm going to start off by making the feathers, these feathers in the back. And I have colors already laid out. I use regular yellow and metallic, jelly purple and metallic purple, jelly blue and metallic blue, jelly orange and metallic red, and the regular green, which will be this part of the bird. You can use whatever colors you'd like, and we can get started. First we need a hook, and you take one yellow and one metallic. I'm going to make three of them, and you need a total of 12. To make the bird. And I had an extra hook, and you can use a pencil or anything, chopstick, anything, and you just place them on here so when you need them, you have them handy. So first take your two yellows, wrap it around the hook four times, then you take your purples, wrap it around twice. It's the same procedure as the bigger peacock. Then you take your blues, your orange and your red, and your green. Place it on the hook like that. Then you take another green, or whatever color you want to make the bird, and place it on there. And that's one. So I'm going to place it on this hook. Just like that. And then we'll make two more. So your yellow's four times around. And your purple twice around, and your other colors that you want to use. You don't have to use the same colors as I'm using, whatever colors you want your peacock to be. Here's number two. Okay, I need to get another jelly. Okay, four times around. And remember, you have to make 12 of these. Now set that aside, and we're going to start on the wings. It's the same procedure as the bigger peacock, if you've made the bigger peacock, but it's going to be shorter. and only 4 attached looms. I'm going to attach, in the Peacock, the other Peacock video, I just did 2 and then left it up to you to do the rest. I'm going to do all 4 here. So you take a single band, place it on the loom, twist it, just so. So a single, and twist it upon itself, and place it on the band, on the loom. And we're going to complete the whole loom. Also, it's only 9 stitches, so let's count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So do 9 also over here. It's a smaller peacock, so the wings will be a little shorter too. Also, for the extension part of the peacock, I'm using the rainbow colors. You can use whatever colors you'd like. So red, orange, yellow, light green, blue, indigo for the, I used a metallic purple, and a purple for purple, for violet. Number 9. And straight configuration, arrows pointing down. Now we can flip it over. So now the arrow is pointing up. We're going to put our capping bands, which are our feathers that we just made. Take one set. Place them on the end. Now we're going to go into the colors that you want to use to make this part. And I laid them out in a separate storage case that I had, and I just put them in different compartments so I can just have them organized. You can make different piles just to make everything good. I'm going to use red for the top part. So you take two reds. Pick up the top part of here and then place it right there. And place that back on. Do the same over here. Take the top off. Take one of the bands and place it right there. And put that on. Same over here. Take the top off. The other band right there. And that's just the hard part. The rest is easy. Take two reds, one here, my next color is orange, and then we're going to do yellow here and we'll be I'm going to use a different yellow because I have a couple different yellows. The thicker the bands I think are better too. So this is two bands just like these. Now, the green, which is going to be a single, and stretched. Then the blue. If you don't have a dark purple, you can use a regular purple. Okay, and that's what it should look like. So, there's two reds here, two oranges, and one yellow, and both of them have two bands. Then we're going to singles here. So now we can loop, pull this back, and just take the green. And these are tight bands, so take your time with it. Pull this back, begin to grab the green, back and grab the green. Okay. I grabbed one of the other feather bands, so we'll fix that. That's why I take your time with this project, so you don't get any mistakes. Okay, so I want to place one of the bands down on the bottom. Place this back on. place this one back on top of that, and it's fixed. The regular green on, and then put the rest. That's good to show you how to fix things. So if that happens to you, this has to be at the bottom, and then you can grab in, pull it. Make sure you grab that. It's good to make mistakes to show you. It's okay. So this is what it should look like. Take one single green band. Loop it through. To tie it together. And then do a slip knot, and now we have one complete. And this is what one looks like. Now we're going to make three more. Same procedure. Okay, arrow is facing down. And single twist ends. Let's make sure 9, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and one more, 9. Thank you. do your capping bands. The two reds. Pick up the top part of your capping band. Place two there and then replace. Pick up the top part. Take one band. Place it as so. And replace. And same here. Okay. Now, I like to flip it over to get the colors like that, or you can keep it that way. Whatever you suit, whatever you like. Okay, two reds, just like that. Oranges. Another row of orange. Two yellows, but only one set. One green. One blue, one dark purple, and one light purple. Okay, now we can start looping. But first, we have to attach this guy to it. So, take the bands out, just like this. Pull them out. Okay, and we're going to align it to the colors that we have here. So we're going to place our light purple on the purple and just match the colors up. Right here, pick up the top green band, place the red right there, and then replace the top green band. Okay, and it should look like that. And now we can start looping this to tie it all together. Grab the green right on the bottom. And start looping. Remember, take your time. There's a lot of bands here. a single green. These on a hook. Same as before. Place them on that band. Okay, slip knot it. And now you can take the rest off the hook. Okay, so now you have two looms attached. And stretch it out. We're going to do another side also. So two more. Same, arrows facing down. Now take your other feathers. Now you cap them your bands. Okay, take your two reds. Pick up the top green, place it back. Top green, take one red. And same here. so it looks more like a rainbow. Two reds. Oranges. Two yellows, but single set. One green. One blue. And one white. Okay, and that's what it should look like. I'm gonna flip it back over. Now we're going to do the same thing and attach. So pull out the bands again. So just put them with the right colors. Okay, again, take off top green, place the red, then replace the top green. Okay, it should look like that. Now we'll loom straight up again. Go back and get the green. Pull this one back, get the green on the bottom. Pull that to get the green. Same as before, single band. Pop these off the moon. and slip knot. Now we can take this off. Now we have three looms connected. So now it's getting to be the shape that we want. Do one more set. Okay, single green. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, and number nine. Now our capping band, so last three. Okay, two reds. Same as before. Okay, take the top green off, place it back on. Reds, orange. set of yellow. One green, one blue, one dark purple, and one light purple. Okay, and now get to do the final connection. Pull these out. Connect. Take off the top, green, place the red, and replace the green. Okay, and now we can loop. Pull this back and get the green on the bottom. make sure everything is equal. See, that's too close, so you want to stretch that. And once everything's stretched out and how you like it, it will be a half circle. Okay, so it should look like that. Okay, you can work with it however you like. Next, we're going to work on the body of the peacock and how to attach it. Okay, so we have this done, and we're going to work on the body. And then once you get the body done, we're going to attach everything with clips. So I used, in this peacock, I didn't put the white that I have in the big peacock. I'm going to put it in the new one. And if you don't want to put the white, you don't have to. And if you see at the end that you don't like how the white looks, you can just cut the white off too, because it's not, it's just an accessory band. Okay, we're going to do a staggered position for the loom. Just like that. And I'm using a dark blue. The color, double banded, and you can start placing as so. An arrow is facing down. This pin, stretch it like that. And then we're doing the same as here. Stretch like that. Then the middle. The neck is going to be a triple band to make it a little thicker. So we're going to do three. Just like that. And do another set of three. Smaller than the bigger peacock also. When you double, and three. Same on the other side. Now we're going to work on the legs. I'm using tan, and you can see The legs are a lot shorter to fit the body. And I use the hook for this part. So I take one single band, wrap it around four times, then take one single twisted and put that band on top. And that's one toe. I'm gonna make two more. So wrap around four times. Single twisted. There's number two. Okay, take one single twisted and place all toes on there. To make the leg, we're going to do add two more stitches of single twisted. Now place that right here. Okay, now we're going to do one more over here. So four times around. Single twisted for one toe. Make two more. Single twist it again. Okay, single twisted in two sets. Now let's do single blue and wrap it around this pin four times. That will help conceal the leg inside the body also. Now we're going to work on the eyes, which I'm using black. You can use beads or whatever you'd like. I'm going to wrap around five times. Five. take your blue, place those bands on here. And they get placed right on the top, two pins. And just like that, separate the eyes. Now we're going to work on the beak, which I'm using one tan, wrapped around four times. Take a double tan. Twist it, just so. Place it just like that. Okay, that's your beak. Now we're going to get another blue. And slide the beak onto the blue. And we're going to put it right here. Okay. Now, in this bird, I don't have the white bands. But I'm going to place the white bands on this one to see what it looks like compared to the father. So you need one white, and we'll place it on this pin. Going up. Okay, another white up. And if you do this process and you don't like it at the end, you can just snip the white bands off. Okay, now we're going to do the structural bands. Take a single blue. Place it just so, with the bottom right here. So it looks like this. Take another single blue. A structural band there. And there. So that's your structural bands. And you already have these connected up top. And now we can start looming. And then when we get to the very top, I'll show you how to make the feathers on the top too. Okay, we're looking for this band on the bottom. Tight here, so just pull it around, it should be looser. Okay, now we're looking for this band. And the other side. Now these are thick, they're triple. So make sure you get all three. It's very tight here. Okay, we're going to look for this middle band, which is the topmost. So it's a little tricky because they're all the same color. Okay, now we're looking for this band, which would be the topmost. I just want to make sure it's all taken correctly. Now we're going to go for the middle. Place the beak through. Now the blue on the sides. Finally the white, which is the accessory. And I'm going to get the middle band between the eyes. Okay, so now I want to show you what the head feathers look like. This is the big peacock. I think that they're too thick for his head, so I made them just single bands with the plume on the top. If you don't like how this looks, you could just put three blue bands through here and slip knot it, and that could be your top feathers. But I'm going to show you how to make this also. So we're first going to get the jelly blue. I'm going to use three of them. And then the metallic blue. And three. Okay, take your jelly, wrap it around four times. Then your metallic, twice. And take a single blue, same color as the bird. Place it on there. Just like that. And make a slip knot. So it looks just like that. Now, what I did to make them more straight, I did two knots. Just in the middle. And you can just keep it like that. You don't even have, for the other bird, I put another knot here. But I'm just going to put one knot for right now. Here's a single, four times around. And then the color of your bird. right in the middle. Okay, just like that. And then we'll do the final one. So now we have three. Place them directly on top. This one I'm going to put another knot just to make it a little longer, more straight. See how if you add the extra knot, it makes it more straight. So we'll place that one right in the middle. I'm going to place another knot in these two. Just like that. Okay, and this is the layout of the bird. Make sure it looks like that. Now we're going to take two bands. Pull it through. Right through the middle. Make a slip knot. Now remember, if you don't want these like that, you can just put three bands, and this could be the top of your head too. Okay, now we'll take it off the loom. Push the beak through the middle part of the nose, well, not nose, the beak bands. Find the eyes, push those through. Okay, now you can see the white part is laying on top. It looks just like the bigger version, but smaller. If you don't like the white part, this is what it looks like without the white. Okay, stretch out the body. Okay, it should just look like right like that. Now we're going to attach the feathers that we just did before, just like this, and I'm going to use clips this time with the bigger bird, I sewed it, and you can also put clips. But since this is a smaller bird, I like how it's more simple with the clips. So take one clip, I'm using C-clip, use whatever you like, place it on one of the green feathers, and then place it right here on above the leg, on a blue. Okay. Now you have one. Go on the other side and do the same thing. Take a clip. Put it on a green. And then this blue. To connect that. Okay. Now you can take another clip. Any part of the green. And connect it to a blue on the back stitches. Just like that. Take another clip. Attach it to the blue. Okay, so you have these excess bands back here. Pull them all together and you can clip them. Just like that. Pull everything through. Make it tighter in the back too to hide more of the clip. This one I just have actually two clips, and it works really well. This one we put a couple clips. Try to pull it tight in the back so the clips are hiding. Work with it. And you have a beautiful peacock. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. This is the white one, the regular one, and the big one, so you can see the size differences. Takes a lot longer time to do him because he's five rainbow looms in the back, and these are only four and shorter. But it's all worth it. They're beautiful. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Please subscribe to Lovely Lovebird Designs, and we'll see you soon.